I'm on you is not from me, it's from God.
There are tribes in the mountains that we haven't even found yet. They haven't heard the gospel message. There are people that have not heard. And that's what drives my heart in the ministry. How can they hear unless somebody's sent? So we go into areas that may be the second or the third or the fourth largest city in the region. And then we pull buses if we can get them, or carts, or like in India, we had tractors with trailers that we rented to bring the people in from the little communities around. And we go into those cities because the major ministries haven't focused there. Paul said, my message and my preaching were not with wise and persuasive words, but with a demonstration of God's power, so that your faith wouldn't rest in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. It's the power of the Spirit that convinces man that God is a reality and Jesus Christ is the risen Lord. Jesus told his disciples, don't just believe in me because of what I say, at least believe because of the evidence of the miracles. And he was the Son of God, he's God himself. And if he said that, I'm not going to say just believe in my fancy preaching, but believe because of what you see. And it is the signs, wonders, and miracles that convince the lost and dying world that Jesus is a risen Lord. There's particular people that came up after the crusade, and they said, we've been praying that somebody would come and tell us about God. They're crying out, who is he? If you're real, show us. How can they believe in the one whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? And how can they preach unless they're sent?
Set apart